Okay, welcome back. So today in this particular video we are going to see about the section of solids. So to tell in detail about section of solids, it is nothing but a continuation of our projection of solids. If we know the basic concept of projection of solids very clearly, the section of solids is very simple. I have told you previously an example. The main necessity of this section of solids is used to identify the hidden parts. Okay, for example, let us take an example. If I am having a pen, so as of now, the refill which is inside this particular pen is not visible. If I try to cut this object, definitely the particular internal parts will be available. That is the major example for this particular section of solids. So you can see the detailed question in our description. Here, a square pyramid is given of size 25 mm and the height of the pyramid is 55 mm. Which is resting with base on HP, where the base edge is perpendicular to VP. So this is very important. The base edge is perpendicular to VP. Okay, so this is for our simple question. This is what we have seen already in our projection of solids. After which we have the topic, after which we have the data for our section of solids. See here, it may be called as a cutting plane, or it may be called as a section plane, or simply it may be tell it is been cut by yam. Okay, so it is having a cutting plane perpendicular to VP and inclined at 30 degree to HP. So let me tell you one thing. So imagine this is your knife. See here, so this is my horizontal plane and this is my vertical plane. Now this knife is parallel to HP and perpendicular to VP. So when if it is parallel to HP, then only it can be inclined to HP. That is a basic concept. So this is what given over here in my problem. See here, it is given very clearly. It is perpendicular to VP and it is inclined to HP. So this is the condition for this particular problem. So imagine if your knife is like this, it can cut only your front view. You take this as a note. So what is the note here is, if the cutting plane is perpendicular to VP and inclined to HP, it can cut your front view. It is a note number one. Okay, and where does it cut? It means the axis at 20 mm from the vertex. What does it mean? So from 20 mm in my axis, so this is my vertex or apex. From here I can measure 20 mm where it is inclined at an angle of 30 degree to my horizontal plane. Okay, now let us try to solve this particular problem. As I told earlier, see the edges is perpendicular to VP. You can see here the edge AD and the edge BC is perpendicular to my reference line, which is nothing but perpendicular to vertical plane. So I have drawn a simple question. I have drawn a square of side 25 mm and then I have drawn the triangular edges. From the center, I have projected the center line. I have had a height of 55 mm, then I completed my front view. So this is a simple question of this particular diagram. Now comes the section of solids. So we are going to draw the projection of sectioned solids. Okay, we are going to draw the projection of sectioned solids. First, let us mark a 20 mm from the vertex. So from here I am measuring and I am having a 20 mm. Okay, so then what I have to do is, I can use my protractor. It is given 30 degree, see here. So here I am going to fix and I am going to measure 30 degree. So in case of a cutting plane, you be very careful. You can take either angle from this side or even this side. It is your option, because whenever we need to draw it, it is your option to draw your cutting plane. So now I am going to take the 30 degree from here. It is coming approximately here. So let me draw it. So it is coming approximately here. Okay, so how to draw a cutting plane? See here, I am having a long dash, I am having a short dash, I am having a long dash. And similarly, at the end it should be darker. At the end it should be darker. And it should consist of a line which is perpendicular to your cutting plane or a section plane. And you can name it as CP, which denotes your cutting plane. Now let us try to identify, see here, the part which is below the knife. The parts which is below the knife only should be in darker, so that I am converting this into a, okay, So this is the remaining part. Once I cut this, the top portion is being removed. To identify this section of solids, see here, these points are only, have been marked only for your understand purpose. See here, the knife is cutting here and the knife is cutting here. Okay, you can see this. This is A2O slant edge and B2O slant edge. Sorry, D2O slant edge. I'm sorry over here. This is D2O. So this is D dash. And similarly, this is B dash to O dash. And then it is C dash to O dash. So it is cutting and slanting edge. So here you can see the slanting edge. This is A2O. This is B2O. This is C2O. And this is D2O. You simply try to project these points towards the slant edge. I have a point here, I have a point here. See here, this projection is very light and very thin. So this point has to be in O to B and O to C. So I have a point here and I have a point here. So only after which the remaining should be darker. See here, I am trying to connect these four points and the remaining part of a base of a square pyramid, it should be darker. It should be darker. And don't forget your slant edge from this cutting part should be also darker. So now I have been completed the sectional top view. So once if I cut and if I look from the top, it is called as a sectional top view. So it is called as a sectional top view. To denote that the knife has been passed here, I have to draw a hatching line which is 45 degree inclined. See here, the hatching line should be of uniform gap and of uniform angle. I hope you can see the hatching line here. So the hatching line should be of a uniform gap and it should be of a uniform angle. There are three angles, 30 degree, 45 degree and 60 degree. Here we can use a 45 degree to hatch it. And you can mention this as, you can write this as, so it is called as a sectional, it is called as a sectional top view. Okay, now let me name it. See here, the knife is cutting here and here. So let me name it over here. This is 1, this is 2, this is 3, and this is my point number 4. So here I can, from if I look from here, I can see 1 dash, I cannot see 4 dash. I can see 2 dash, I cannot see 3 dash. The prime objective of section of solids is to draw the true shape after cutting an object. So what is called true shape in the sense, once I cut the object, if I look from the top, what is the shape it looks like? That is called as a true shape. Okay, to draw the true shape, what should I do is, I need to draw a line which is parallel to my section plane. You be very careful. The line what you are going to draw is an axillary cutting plane which should be parallel to your primary cutting plane. And it should be very careful. It should be away from your diagram. So to draw this, what I am doing is I am drawing a line which is very thin and light and I am naming it as X, X dash. So this X, X dash is my axillary cutting plane. So after which what I have to do, wherever the knife is cutting, for example you can see the knife is cutting in this slant edge, the knife is cutting in this particular slant edge. From there, you try to draw a line which is perpendicular to your axillary cutting plane. I repeat again. So from the point where the knife is cutted, from there you try to draw a line which is perpendicular to your axillary cutting plane. See here, for which I am keeping my scale which is perpendicular to my axillary thing and then I am drawing a line. Okay, so that is only one final step. So in order to draw my true shape, what you have to do is, if your cutting plane is here, you try to measure for a true shape from your reference line to the bottom view. Okay, so let me see here, from my reference line, so this is the line which is indicating, only for your understanding I am writing, this is the line for 1,4, this is the line for 2,3. See here, I am going to use my compass. So from my reference line, I am measuring 1. So where is 1 here? The 1 is here. I am cutting an arc. And similarly, from here I am measuring my 4.
from here
I am cutting an arm.
And similarly, from here I am measuring my 3
and I am cutting an arm.
So from my reference line I am measuring number 2, from there I am cutting a point. So this will be the,
if I join all these points,
so this will be my particular true shape of the particular object. So this is my 1, this is 2, so this is 3, and this is finally 4.
So here also we have to give our hatching. I already told you that the hatching should be of a 45 degree. See here.
So this is called as a true shape.
Okay.
So this is what asked in my question. So I need to draw the sectional top view and I need to find out the true shape along with my particular elevation. So with which we have completed this particular problem.